Michael Jackson's first encounter with the ranch came when he visited Paul McCartney, who was staying there during the filming of their Say 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 music video. Jackson was enamored with the location, not only because it was breathtakingly beautiful, but also refreshingly remote. According to LaToya Jackson, Michael expressed interest to her in someday owning the property at the time. Even though Jackson had just completed rebuilding his former family home in his image, which included a small zoo and Disney-inspired attractions, he had an ambitious vision for the property and wanted to use it as a retreat from the outside world, a magical place of wonder. So, to what lengths did Michael Jackson go to in order to construct his fantastical childhood dream? Here's the detail. Originally known as the Zacalanderas Ranch, the massive spread of land spanning across 2,700 acres in California's Santa Ynez Valley, the property was purchased by William Boone in 1977. A successful property developer, Boone was so enchanted with the property that he wanted to make it the perfect home for him and his family. He started by renaming the estate Sycamore Valley Ranch, a name the property has now reverted back to. Drawing on his years of experience building luxurious homes, Boone enlisted the help of architect Robert Altivers to design the main structures on the property, and the two of them spent more than 2 years coming up with the perfect plans and designs for the estate. What had been an undeveloped stretch of cowboy country would soon be replaced by Boone's dream world, complete with a 13,000 square foot main house and multiple outbuildings, spectacular gardens, and a 4-acre lake with a 5-foot waterfall and a stone bridge. "I had a desire to express everything I had learned in 15 years of home building," the developer said. He had considered converting the property to a country club, but little did he know that the result of his years of experience would soon become one of the most well-known properties in the world. Initially, the vendors were asking more than $30 million for the sprawling estate. However, Jackson's lawyer John Branca was eventually able to negotiate a remarkable discount, reducing the price down to $19.5 million. The property was initially purchased by a trust with Michael Jackson's lawyer and his accountant as trustees, for reasons of privacy. The arrangement was later rescinded by Jackson in April 1988, and at the age of 29, he became the ultimate owner of his dream property. In Jackson family style, his parents were informed he was moving out the family home while watching Entertainment Tonight. Jackson immediately renamed the property Neverland Ranch, the fantasy island in the story of Peter Pan, a boy who never grew up. Neverland was Michael Jackson's attempt to escape and recapture his youth, as well as indulge in the dream of an ideal childhood. Jackson then immediately went on a decade-long spree creating his vision, spending nearly double what he spent purchasing the property. He ordered the construction of an amusement park, purchasing 18 rides between 1990 and 1997, including a carousel, a sea dragon, a wipeout, 4 zippers, a turtle train, a lolly swing, a samba balloon, Dumbos, Dragos, a Ferris wheel, and a bumper car building with 20 bumper cars. Some of the rides featured a prominent label that proclaimed, "Designed especially for Michael Jackson." He also constructed a 50-seat movie theater with a snack bar serving popcorn, candy, and ice cream. A zoo was constructed, complete with elephants, giraffes, chimpanzees, crocodiles, snakes, a bear, llamas, a reptile house, and exotic birds, which he had to let go because they sang too loud during the mating season. Looming large as you entered was a bulky turreted railway station, Catherine Station, named for his mother. The Catherine miniature steam engine was a prominent feature. Inside the mansion, it was filled with toys and paintings of the King of Pop himself. A life-sized figure of a butler with a tray of cookies in his hand greeted Jackson's guests in the enormous kitchen. There was also a games room with a huge variety of arcade-style video games, a penny press machine, and a photo booth. The library was crammed with bright leather-bound, never-opened books, which made all of it seem like a set design. Apart from the main house, there was a guest house. Each of the rooms within was numbered, hotel-style. In total, there were 22 buildings on the land. The annual cost of Neverland was $5 to $6 million. It had more than 120 staff on a $1 million per year payroll catering to his every whim, who all had to smile as a condition to keep their jobs. Michael Jackson often opened up the amusement park to groups of disadvantaged children. Inside the walls of the movie theater, Jackson built rooms with hospital beds for terminally ill and bedridden kids he often invited to his ranch. Neverland was visited by thousands of fans when Jackson was alive, many of whom were allowed in the property, though it was never open to the public. Charity fundraisers were often held, at which guests would be charged a $1,000 entrance fee to pass through the gates. Visitors said that Neverland smelled like cinnamon rolls, vanilla, and candy, and sounded like children laughing. It was just like heaven. You never wanted to leave.